Hey, what's happening YouTube? Thanks for tuning back into the channel today, right here with the Rust Belt Mechanic. You have rolled into another episode of Nifty Tools of the Week. We've got four different nifty tools here for you guys to enjoy. These are tools that have helped me get through my week here at the dealership, working flat rate, working hard. Hopefully you guys enjoy them. First set that we're gonna come to today is this awesome 14-piece socket set from SP Tools. This one is going to have a wide variety of different impact sockets for you. The part number on this one is SP50014. Like I said, 14 pieces here for you. And the cool thing about this is it's a set that has both the nylon non-marring style sockets here, as well as a 5-piece standard socket set in with it, along with the universal joint, the impact version. All this is half inch drive, by the way. The 3-inch extension bar, as well as the 5-inch extension bar too. The sizes are pretty standard for what you would see. The lug nut sockets, which are the non-marring ones over here, are in 14, 17, 19, 21, 22, and 24, which covers just about every single style of lug nut that you're going to deal with in day-to-day use. Now, what I really like about these is that they're color-coded, so even if this EVA foam tray, which is a really actually high-quality, dense foam tray, that it's not going to be those cheap ones that you get off, you know, from China or something that just flake away really fast. It's a real high-density foam, and it's got a harder plastic top to it, so it's not going to flake away from the top section. So, nice storage with it. I like that it's very well organized in a tight location. Usually, a lot of the blow-molded cases and stuff, they spread out the tools too much, takes up too much space, but this one, I do like this one. I like that they're color-coded, like I said, because if it does get dirtier or something like that, you're able to know that, okay, when I'm grabbing for a 19, I'm just pulling this yellow socket right here. Really quick, easy to be able to do it. 5 pieces in the standard sockets. Those are going to be for the smaller sizes, 10, 12, 13, 14, and 18 millimeters on those respectively. I really like this socket set. It's great for a beginner set because it does come with the standard smaller impact sockets, as well as the wheel lug nut sockets. Great for a beginner mechanic. Has those nylon sockets, so you guys aren't gonna be messing up any kind of chrome, fancy, expensive wheels. Really great kit. You go over to sptools-usa.com. They've got these right on there for about $224. You can compare that to any kind of Snap-on or Mac full set of impact sockets alone. That's gonna be like 20-30% off of that one, but anywhere you go, you're not gonna see impact sockets, extension bars, universal, and nylon sockets on the same set. I think it's a pretty great buy for a pretty nifty tool. Next tool that we're going to come to today, we're going to get right into this Irwin Vice Grip 10-inch extra grip plier set. So the part number on this one is going to be IRHT82576. And this is the new designed Irwin style vice grips. What I really like about these is they take a lot less effort to pull for however much tension that is going onto the head. Really crazy story about this one is that my uncle's brother, actually from a different marriage, he actually designed this set of pliers right here with this specialty. It looks like it's got an extra little arm off to the side. That's how it's able to get the, I guess from what they say, 20% better gripping power. The cool story behind that one is he produced these and he made this idea about 4 or 5 years ago. And he made this for a couple of guys coming back overseas from war in Afghanistan. And he was saying, you know, a lot of these guys had lost some feeling in their hands, couldn't squeeze things very well, but still wanted to be able to work in the garage, work in the shop. So he made a set of vice grips that were easier for him to pull. So they pitched that to Irwin, bought it up, vice grip made them. There they are today. So not only do they clamp the 20% easier than any of the other vice grips, they are also the quick release. So the quick release pad handle right here is able to flip them open a whole lot easier than other vice grips also. I like that they are from Irwin, and because they are Irwin, you can find them just about anywhere. You can find them at Lowe's, Home Depot carries them every once in a while. You get them on Amazon, and you can get them for pretty cheap. This set, I believe, over on Amazon costs right around 15 bucks. I'll be sure to put a link in the description to that one. Really neat design. Maybe you guys check these out, throw those in your box too. Third up on this week's Nifty Tools list is gonna be the Snap-on FDX sockets. Now, I know you guys haven't seen this in my toolbox before because I just couldn't bring myself to purchase them. They're the newest thing from Snap-on, the Flank Drive Extra Sockets. Now, the design of these is something that I guess that's newer to the market, and they're able to grip up to 50% better. That's what they advertise, at least. I've had my chance to use these over the last week or so here, and I'd have to say I'm kind of impressed by them. They definitely do the job on the grip. I use them a lot of times when you have rusted, rounded bolts. Living here in the Rust Belt, that's pretty much an everyday occurrence. I'm always grabbing the 15-16 millimeter because I gotta do these exhaust recalls on these big 5500 trucks, and never fails. The exhaust clamp bolts and nuts are always rusted to crap. These things have gripped them every single time without rounding them off. These sockets, compiled with a really good impact, you're going to snap the actual fastener off before you round it every single time. I think it's absolutely amazing. What they've done is a really good job. Now, to get this amazing set of sockets, you are going to have to pay an astronomical price as well. This specific part number is 215YSFSMY, and this is the larger set, metric 6 to 20 millimeter in the 3/8 drive deep chrome sockets. The chroming on these is fantastic. Obviously, Snap-on's chroming is great, second to none. They distinct these sockets with the indented collar, the collet, compared to the standard Snap-on sockets, which is going to have the collet smooth all the way down. So if you guys do end up having the standard sockets out as well as the FDX sockets, you can tell the difference between the two to put them back into the set. I really like the Snap-on magnetic trays that these come with standard. And of course, they better come with something awesome as well as a nice little case to go onto it for the 414 bones for a socket set. You heard right, $414 for a 3/8 socket set. Never thought I would have said that, but if you want the best in the industry, which unfortunately, I'd have to say these are pretty much one of the best ones that you guys are gonna find, you're gonna have to pay that outrageous premium price. Now, let's look into what makes these sockets grip so well and see what they have to do. You can see kind of the shape of these sockets are a little bit different. And from what I see in here on these is that the tolerances on these are actually really, really tight. So on putting these on standard sockets, so say if this is gonna be like a 18 millimeter here, it's gonna fit really tight on standard non-marred up 18 millimeter sockets. So that's why I usually only get these out for the rusted, crusted, kind of bolts from up in here in Ohio. As you can see here up in the corners of the collets, which would be grabbing onto the corners of the fastener, they look to be a little bit more rounded. Now, what this reminds me of most is gonna be over in the SP Tools, their quad drive wrenches. Let me grab one of those just to compare. The SP Tools quad drive wrenches, as you can see, in the open end side of the wrench, they have the same exact design. Gonna be in there, the little rounded indents into that open end that grabs the fastener, supposedly advertised to give 50% better gripping power on it. I wonder where that design is gonna work from. So I think that this is gonna work just as well. So you guys are gonna have to stay tuned because I'm actually gonna be doing some wrench comparisons on open end wrenches to see what's the big hubbub with all of their special Flank Drive Plus, Quad Drive, Extra Drive, but that'll be in a different video. Last but certainly not least in the quintuplet of awesome Nifty Tools of the Week is gonna be the SP Tools big freaking pry bar that I've got sitting here in the back. Part number on this one is going to be SP33814. This is going to be a 1400 millimeter as advertised, which if you put that over into inches is right around 55 inches long. Comparing that one to Snap-on's 54 inch long set of pry bar that they've got for them, this is a very nice comparable pry bar. The handle on this one I like even more because it's bigger in diameter than the other manufacturers. It's big all the way to the end. It doesn't have that nose down collet that a lot of the other pry bar sets have. I also like that it's got more of the rubberized design than the hard plastic. I'm not really a big fan of the Snap-on hard plastic style pry bars. I know they've got a couple of different ones, but the grip on this one I think blows the Snap-on and the Mac pry bars out of the water. On top of that, it's got the striking end, which normally on a 4 foot tall pry bar, are you really going to be striking the end of it that much? No, you're going to be hanging every ounce of weight you can off of this to pry some gigantic control arms or bars or whatever you're really messing up when you have to use a 4 foot pry bar. This thing is absolutely amazing. Like I said, 55, 56 inches long. The finish on it is awesome. It's got the black hardened coating to it, so it's not gonna be rusting, crusting all over the place. It's a fantastic hard tool. I've put my full weight at like 275 pounds onto this bad boy, never budging an inch. This thing isn't gonna move. Big old piece of steel. Now, price-wise comparison, to the Snap-on 54 inch pry bar is going to be coming in at 220 bones. We go over to SPTools-USA's website. They've got sale running on this one right now, 199 bucks. I think it's a steal of a deal for this big of a pry bar, something that's going to be just as high quality, even better. I like the grip a lot better. You know, it's something that I'm definitely going to be holding on to and using for a long time to come. It's not ever gonna need replaced in any way, shape, or form. I would definitely recommend for you guys to pick up this big freaking pry bar from SP Tools USA. And in good fashion with some of the early nifty tools of the week, I wanted to point out a couple of nifty content creators in the tool and automotive fields. The one I really wanted to point out to you guys on YouTube is One Man Shop. One Man Shop is a really good at-home channel. He does everything from a couple of builds in his garage, some tool reviews. He just did a great video on a Snap-on tool haul. And the coolest thing, he just did a 1,000 subscriber giveaway. Congratulations on hitting 1,000 subs there. He gave away a free Snap-on ratchet. That was a pretty neat giveaway for them. So make sure you go and check out One Man Shop. And the next content creator that I really wanted to point out is not on YouTube, but they are actually over on Facebook and especially in any kind of podcast. That is Grease the Wheels. This podcast was made, you know, a couple of years ago by a couple of guys that work in the automotive industry. Uncle Jimmy, who is the main talk show host there on the program, he does an amazing job. He's hilarious. He doesn't hold a thing back, which is what I absolutely love about him. He shows everything from the highlights to the dark side of the automotive industry. And for having a half an hour show once a week, usually on Wednesday evenings, it's something I definitely look forward to listening here at the shop every single week. He's hilarious. You guys should go and check them out. I'll be sure to put a link to their podcast in the description below. Make sure you go and check them out. That's about all I have for you guys this evening. We have gone through some amazing nifty tools and we've got tons more nifty tools to be coming down the pipeline here in the next couple of weeks. I've actually got a couple more sitting here, but we're waiting on their manufacturers to be able to get them out enough on time so when I premiere them, you guys will actually be able to buy them. So lots of those tool videos are gonna be coming up, as well as Duramax content coming up big time. We've been working with Truckmaster at Diesel Pros up in Schwartz Creek, Michigan. They've had the old Dirty Max here for better part about a week and a half now. And this next weekend, I'm gonna be going back and picking her up. The HSP diesel kit that we're putting onto it is the amazing compound turbo kit. I am so looking forward to this one. More boost, more power. If you guys like the Duramax content, make sure you keep an eye out for that one. Thanks for tuning in again today, guys. I appreciate it. And as always, you guys stay awesome.